himself here against the Thunder Kid. Lito Adiwang. Crowd inside the Mall of Age Arena behind the latest sensation from Team Lakay. Outside leg kick from Pongsudi Mitsadit, the Muay Thai North Thailand champion. 72-17 Muay Thai record, 49 knockouts. Thunder Kid, a two-time regional Wushu champion, also a regional Muay Thai champion. BJJ Malaysia gold medalist in Johor. All blue belt BJJ Malaysia silver medalist. On a six match winning streak. A high kick there from the Thunder Kid. And here comes the Thunder. Here comes the Lightning. Down goes Pongsudi Mitsadit. This place has gone bananas. The Thunder Kid. The Thunder Kid. Fourth hammer coming down on Pongsudi Mitsadit.
Survived. He was able to weather the storm, keep a nice tight guard as Lito Adiwang unloaded on Pongsudi Mitsadit.
What a start from Lito Adiwang. The Thunder Kid brought the thunder, brought the lightning, brought the hail. And down they go to one knee, now back up to a standing position. Adiwang with a takedown, nicely done, goes to side control.
Oh, beautiful redirect, puts Pongsudi Mitsadit on his back, but he's got that underhook on that side. Now, Lito Adiwang's going for that scarf hold, key lock. You can see him trying to shut that arm into his legs. Looks like it might be a kimura right there, I can see it.
Is he gonna make it seven wins in a row, the Thunder Kid? And no, says Pongsudi Mitsadit, takes the back standing of the Filipino.
Wow, what grit coming out of Pongsudi Mitsadit as he was able to survive two extremely bad positions. And now he's got the back of Lito Adiwang. Lito Adiwang's going to look to try to separate those hands and spin and go chest to chest.
The aggressor meter off the charts for Lito Adiwang at the start of this contest. Not even halfway through the first round.
Yeah, looks like he's trying to attempt a kimura lock there on the hands as he tried to roll through. Good job by Piak to hold that body lock nice and tight and maintain positioning. You can see that Lito Adiwang, I don't know if you can see, but he's got a kimura grip on that arm right there, and he's going to try to use it to sweep and reposition.
Adiwang has not lost a match since 2014. A 90% finishing rate, you can see why, including a massive amount of first round finishes. He's had five in his last six bouts. Have been first round finishers. He's looking for another one here.
He's still going.
He's done it! He's done it! He's done it! It's goodnight, Irene! The Thunder Kid has arrived! The storm hits Manila! Lito Adiwang!
Once he got that kimura grip, he was not letting it go. Even though he was giving up his back, when Pongsudi Mitsadit had the back of Lito Adiwang, Lito Adiwang immediately started looking for that kimura grip. Once he had that grip, he went for the sacrifice throw, ended up on top, cranked on the kimura. Oh, beautifully done. What a submission.
Eight first round wins in 11 career victories now for the Thunder Kid.
Look at that. Takes it up over the head. Beautifully done. I think he learned that from Joshua Pashiao from the passion lock. Almost the same. Another beautiful submission win from Team Lakay. Look at this. He steps over the head, locks it into position, starts cranking on the arm. Beautifully done by Lito Adiwang.
The Thunder Kid Kimura, Lito Adiwang, gives thanks to the big man upstairs. What a victory for him. What a victory for Team Lakay and a victory for the Philippines. The Thunder Kid has arrived. And I know Rich Franklin, who discovered him in One Warrior Series, is loving that performance. My word. Lito Adiwang, the real deal. Seven wins in a row for the Thunder Kid from Baguio City. 26 years old, two-time Philippine National Wushu champion. Let's go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kemp Cheng, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 2 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of Kimura, Lito
first one for all the beans in the Philippines. It's Martin Nguyen and Kevin Belingon, the world interim bantamweight title. They'll test each other out early. They'll see what each other has to offer. There's tremendous respect between the two, but both said they would finish each other. Nguyen said he'd choke out Belingon. Belingon said, I'll knock him out any round I want to. Both of them carry tremendous power, particularly in their hands.
Martin knows they're very well matched in the striking area, but he believes he's gonna have a wrestling advantage, and he wants to show that wrestling in the second, third rounds. So expect him to kind of dance with Kevin and see what Kevin has to offer on the feet, because we've seen this swagger come out of Martin Nguyen where he drops his hands, consistently drifting from left to right, and also changing stances.
That right hand of Belingon is cocked and ready. Martin testing the distance, flicks out a jab, outside leg kick, second one of the bout so far from Belingon. Fake again there from Nguyen. Shoots in, and a bit of a head clash on the way in there. Belingon just checking for any damage. There will be a moment to perhaps have the ringside position take a look at Belingon, or maybe just Olivia Cost.
That mullet acts like a pretty good helmet too, Michael. You can see the clash of heads right there as Martin came in. He ducked underneath. Kevin saw it coming in as he threw the right hand, but had the arms in the right spot, ready to defend the takedown. But as Martin came up, he threw a nice little right hand.
Now, entry tell rules and athlete is allowed 5 minutes for recovery and examination. If they're unable to continue, an official decision will be given, but we're okay to go on here. Big tension inside the Mall of Asia Arena. Will we see another Filipino world champion? Or will Martin Nguyen become a historic three-division champion?
Martin's diving down. He's not really changing levels. He's just bending over, trying to go for that double leg. Really got to change levels with your legs. You got to lower your level down to get that takedown effectively.
Belingon like a ticking time bomb, like a hand grenade. Once he pulls the pin, he explodes on his opponent. Will he pull the pin here in the first round? Controlling center cage, looks for the outside leg, does Martin Nguyen.
Martin continues to chase takedowns like that. Look for Kevin to time a knee.
Look for Martin to time that devastating right hand. Belingon edges forward, resets now. The man with the mighty mullet. Nguyen dancing, inviting. Outside crescent kick there from Belingon.
Sidestep.
Took from Belingon, the silencer with the outside leg kick.
Did you see that wild right hand they threw as they exited? Kevin Belingon does that so beautifully. Right as they're exiting the exchange or the clinch, he unleashes a huge right or left hand.
Fakes the hook off the lead hand as Belingon fakes the right cross as Martin Nguyen. Careful not to shoot in sloppily on Belingon.
Looks like I had my timing wrong with the second, third round. Nguyen immediately going after the wrestling. But he's kind of diving in with his head down, not really changing levels properly on the double leg. So kind of going after like a rugby tackle almost on his takedowns.
Trying to push him back from center cage. Thought about the right hand. Front kick there from Nguyen. More of a punt kick though. Had some stuff behind him. Chance go up again for Kevin Belingon. Thought about the Wushu sidekick. End of the first round, we go to the town. It's one championship, green of guilt, live from Manila in the Philippines.
Look at this, Kevin headhunting, going up top. Look at this, watch the exchange. Immediately, as soon as they exit the clinch, Kevin swings wildly. He's got to be careful on leaving his head up like that, but also Martin's got to be careful not to get caught on something on the way out.
I want that king down the middle and get ready to drop the lid.
And there is Martin Nguyen's wife, Brooke. Great to have her here at Cape Side, supporting her husband as always. And there's Master Fari Soliowski, head coach of Team KMA out of Sydney.
Man, Michael, I've never had a family member compete. I've always had friends, teammates, really close compadres competing in the cage. I can't imagine what it's like to have the father of your children inside the cage competing with everything he's got.
Second round, set for five. It's a sellout inside the Mall of Asia Arena. It's the main event for the interim bantamweight world title. Australia and Vietnam versus the Philippines. Martin Nguyen and Kevin Belingon. Nguyen up on the balls of his feet. Switching stance here.
Kevin has slightly adjusted his stance. His left hand is a little bit higher and a little bit extended normally, so maybe it's to counter that right hand of Martin Nguyen. You can see the nice wide stance of Kevin, which usually sets up that front push kick and also it sets up the spin.
There's that punt kick again. And a whipping head kick from Martin Nguyen. Side kick to the knee. Fell short for Kevin Belingon.
Martin sidesteps very well. Especially when he sidesteps, he's sidestepping to the power side of Belingon. So you can see him as he's moving away. If Kevin can time it right, he could throw that right hand and catch Martin as he's coming around to the power side.
Let's see if Nguyen can find range with the cranium cracker, the headache maker, the overhand right. There's that Wushu sidekick from Belingon. A powerful Filipino in the red trunks. Fake there from Nguyen. In and out from Martin Nguyen. Haven't seen Belingon pull the pin yet. Fades a little rough. Drop down levels momentarily. Fakes level change again.
Caught Martin on the shuffle. Trying to ollie shuffle, and he caught him with that left hand as he spins right there.
There was the turning back kick to the liver. The one that sent Andrew Leone reeling last time out. Jab from Nguyen at full extension.
Michael, we've seen so many members of Team Lakay put on the performances of a lifetime. Geje back in Macau against Adriano Moraes. We've seen Fulling just get better and better. These guys are putting on shows, and this is Kevin's moment to not only capture his first world title, but really to announce to the world that Team Lakay is for real.
Nguyen's team believes that the further this one went, the more tired Belingon would become and the stronger Martin Nguyen would grow.
Well, Kevin's never seen those championship rounds. And look, he puts everything he has into these shots and he's missing a lot of these wild hooks. That's gonna take energy out of him, especially if we see the fourth and fifth round.
Is there any sense of vengeance here after Martin Nguyen knocked out his teammate Edwards Belay? That was when Nguyen captured the tonight.
That's the fifth takedown that Belingon stuffed. Martin's got to put together some combinations before threatening the takedown like that. There's that hammer over right hand.
Telegraph that overhand right. Belingon, will we see the little man flurry with that incredible power?
So he could throw that right hand, get Belingon to lift up his hands, and then shoot in for the takedown. Use that weapon as a setup. Get people thinking about it, because you know the entire world knows he wants to throw it. Hide it behind the takedown.
Holding! jab lands again as Bellingham came close to the punch. Upping the intensity, 70 seconds left in the second round. Another hook from the Filipino. A cutting side kick to the thigh from Belingon.
Martin's a little bit too close in distance for that. You can see how quickly he closes the distance as Martin tries to spin as well. Kevin likes to have a little bit more space between his opponents when he throws that spinning attack.
Ewan said he wanted to bring the heat, Mitch. Is he bringing the heat here in Manila tonight so far?
I think he's trying to get a read on Kevin, you know? I've sparred with Kevin. I know how hard it is to get a read on what he's doing because he moves so explosively. I mean, he threw a punch, he missed the punch, and it almost knocked me down. He didn't even hit me. It's incredible the speed at which he throws attacks.
Spinning heel kick there from Martin Ewan. Drifts back to center ring, does a little shuffle. Pops out the jab to Belingon. Final 10 seconds of the round. An intriguing contest. It's edge of the seat stuff here in Manila. Side kick negates the overhand right, and then we go to the tag.
It's interesting how Martin, he anticipates the bound and he takes an extra couple seconds to break like that. You know, he kind of acknowledges that and he leads the way with that. Here it is, look at the shuffle. Boom, left hand landed by Kevin. Beautiful left hand as Martin was trying to adjust stances right there. You can see just how Kevin drops his head to protect from that right hand as he's swinging wildly. Interesting second round.
And this is the man that the winner will most likely meet later this year. Bibiano Fernandes, the Bantamweight World Champion, sidelined with a foot injury. Says he'll be competitive again by October.
Nguyen, not on the stool.
Nguyen may be sending a mental message to Kevin Belingon, not taking a seat between rounds. A sellout crowd here in Manila. It's the hottest ticket in town. It's one championship.
Round 3.
An interesting second round. Both the first and second rounds were very close.
Both men throwing the heavy leather early on. Ewan fakes a takedown, throws that punt kick.
I like how he did that. He was possibly looking for an overhand to come up with that left hook, but he chose to throw the kick instead.
Fakes a front kick to Belingon. Ewan goes to the midsection, goes to the high inside thigh.
Like how Martin's mixing up the weapons. Inside leg kick, front push kick.
Belingon needs to try and close down the movement of Ewan. Step across inside thigh kick. Ewan goes up to the rib cage. Fake slow again does Ewan.
Both these guys look like they're prepared to go the full 25 minutes. They look just as fresh now as they did in the first couple minutes of the first round.
There has never been a question mark surrounding the fuel tank of any man from Team Lakay at the altitude they train at.
Man, you get up there and you start training and your lungs start to close up on you. It's a very interesting phenomenon to train at elevation like that if you're not used to it. And when these guys are raised in elevation, they don't just go there and train, they were born at that height.
We're talking about Baguio City and the Philippines, the home of Team Lakay, that boasts the likes of Kevin Belingon, Edward Falayan, Danny Kingan, Geje Eustaquio, and more. A little bit of a shuffle again here from Nguyen. Want to start to see both of these men committing a lot more here. And Belingon tries to. Wicked left hook there from Kevin Belingon. Goes to the body now to the Filipino.
He's had a lot of success inside the close, dirty boxing type exchanges, especially when Nguyen's starting to back up.
Remember, Nguyen said he did not want it to go to the judges tonight. Has in his last two contests against Bibiano Fernandes and against Christian Lee. Lost in his bantamweight title bid to Bibiano Fernandes. Razor thin decision. to the Brazilian. High kick there from Belingon.
I like how Nguyen came up with an uppercut off that failed takedown attempt. He's starting to mix things up a little bit, the shootbox type style.
Adjustment of the trunks there for Belingon. 2 minutes 20 remaining, third round of five. And our main event, Before Olivia Coles checks it out, gives the AOK to continue.
We got doctors on hand, but we don't have any tailors to fix the situations like that.
It's Manila. There's a lot here. They make great suits, Mitch. Sure we can find one in a hurry. Left hook there from Belingon. Martin Nguyen. You want to see a little more pepper here from Nguyen.
When you're the champion, you're the most hunted man in the entire organization, especially when you hold titles in multiple divisions. So there's a lot of tape on Martin. People are constantly studying him. You know, from what people know what Martin wants to do. So there's a lot of people that are fine-tuning their strategies when it comes to, you know, Martin Nguyen, and that's what Team Lakay is best at. So it's not like Martin's not trying to be exciting, not trying to be explosive, but his opponents are just coming more.
And the high kick from Belingon. Yes, since then the ticking time bomb may be ready to explode. Belingon launching the heavy artillery. 1:10 remaining in the third. Martin Nguyen staying patient. A cerebral punch.
That uppercut as Martin Nguyen started to close that distance, and now he's putting punches together.
Martin Nguyen double jab.
This is what Kevin wants. He wants to get comfortable and throw these shots. This is what he does best. Martin Nguyen has so many weapons. He needs to utilize the wrestling. Back Kevin up against the cage, force a takedown. Some scrambling, drain on Kevin a little bit.
We've seen Kevin unleash some power. Celebrators, have any of them affected the two-division champion, though, Mitch?
Doesn't look like it. Kevin's hit Martin with some big shots, and Martin's really not fazed by it. That front push kick, or that kind of that whipping front kick that he's throwing, is very effective. It's cutting through the guard of Belingon, and it's landing. It's not doing a lot of damage, but it's scoring.
The thing about Martin Nguyen, he's constantly on the move. He's never a stagnant target. Completely different to the last five opponents. Belingon has competed again and beat him. And Belingon having trouble tonight, closing down the movement of Martin Nguyen. He'll get a chance to recover from the accidental groin shot here.
The most devastating right hand in all of ONE Championship just went a little bit low right there. So that's gotta hurt. Usually puts people to sleep.
Seconds left on the clock, so as soon as they recommence, it will be over this round. But Belingon is allowed 5 minutes for recovery and medical examination.
Now we're getting into the fourth round, and this is typically where we see Martin Nguyen really start to do his best work.
I wonder if they shouldn't get those shorts replaced between rounds for Kevin Belingon. They may be annoying him, but also the risk of maybe one of Martin's feet, if he kicks him, getting caught in the trunks. There are 2 seconds left in the round, but Belingon is allowed 5 minutes for recovery. If he is unable to continue, an official decision will be given. That is the end of the round, and we go to the taps. Okay, Mitch Chilson, let's play coach here for a moment. If you're in the corner of the two-division champion, Martin Nguyen, what are you telling Martin to do?
Well, let's see what he was doing here in the third round. Boom, landing the overhand right. You know, he's trying to mix up these weapons. I'd like to see him, you know, fake the overhand right and then set up that takedown. Throw the overhand, see how Kevin reacts. Throw the overhand again, but then go in for the takedown. Try to put Kevin on his back. Take him out of this realm, because Kevin is kind of falling into into his rhythm and he's landed some big strikes. What do I think Kevin should do? Kevin needs to push the action a little bit. He needs to try to shut down the movement, back Martin up against the cage and let go of some of these big strikes, utilizing that jab and also that leg kick. I'd like to see Kevin start kicking the legs of Martin again to start slowing down some of that movement.
What a night it's been so far here in Manila. Great to see Kenzo Gracie flying. And one championship trending on Twitter here in the Philippines. They touch gloves. This, the penultimate round, 4 of 5. Ewan fakes and faints. He drifts off to his right, staying away from the power hand of Belingon. Thrust out the jab, does the Aussie. Belingon fakes. We're in deep water now. Ewan with an outside thigh kick. Belingon tried to counter with those heavy hands.
Martin's movement is exceptional. He's evading the counter strikes of Belingon very well, consistently moving his forward. But if Belingon starts to close the distance a little bit more, he might be able to connect on some of these shots.
Oh, pump kick there, and a counter left hook from Belingon. Throws the right down the center corridor. And Martin Ewan, a little too slick, a little too evasive. Belingon's got to find a way to close down the angles of Martin Ewan. Ewan fakes the right hand. Ewan can be so frustrating to take on. The distance, the angles, the timing, the evasion of the two division champion. Is the distance a problem for Belingon tonight, Mitch?
I think it's the distance and it's also the reach. And you can't quite reach Martin.
He reached him on the
change the tide of this match. The scoring is probably very close.
Belingon, center cage. Fires out the left hook again. Now Ewan takes center cage. Belingon fakes the jab. Ewan shoots in, and Belingon stuffs the takedown attack.
Takedown of Martin Nguyen, and that's gonna score as well. Kevin is able to control and dictate where this match is taking place.
There's the overhand right from Ewan. There's the jab from the Australian. Belingon looking to edge the distance. Closing on Ewan, with those hands, he swings to the body, and Ewan gets out of dodge.
Kevin might need to start taking a little bit more risks, start pushing forward with this action, because I don't know how the judges, how are they gonna see this? Are they gonna see the striking superiority and the movement of Martin Nguyen, or are they gonna see the aggression of Kevin Belingon?
Ewan goes to the outside thigh. 1:45 remains of the 4th of 5 rounds. Wicked left hook from Belingon. Hasn't found the target cleanly though.
Just the reach, his arms are just not long enough to touch Nguyen. He's throwing a lot of shots, but they're just not anywhere close to Martin.
Belingon sets the right hand here. Front kick there from Ewan. Ewan's so quick twitch, the way he moves around, snaps out the jab. Fake again from Ewan. Belingon wants to set a power silver. Ewan does it. The touch kick to the ribs of the Australian. Under a minute remaining in this round. This crowd wants Belingon to pull the trigger. They want him to unload. They're all on the edge of their seats inside the massive mall of Asia Arena. There's the right hand from Martin Nguyen. And you just get a feeling the hairs on the back of your neck. At some stage, Belingon's going to pull out all the stops. Belingon's going to go hell for leather. Final seconds. As Mitch said, it could take one big shot to swing the pendulum and to turn the tide. And it looks like we're going to have to wait to the fifth and final round to find it.
There's still like 10 seconds left as we're walking away.
So
that frustration
round remaining.
Is that gamesmanship? What do you think that is?
Brooke Muren looking very nervous, playing with the rings here, cage side. The kids are back home in Sydney with her mum. She's a part of the sellout crowd inside the Mall of Asia Arena.
Let's take a look at some of the past action here. Kevin Belingon goes airborne right now as he goes headhunting to entertain the crowd. But then Martin was able to answer back with a beautiful left hook, and then he came right up underneath. I think this is where he sets up the uppercut, but we just missed it. Nice shots overall by both opponents. Michael, tough call. How do you see the first four rounds?
You want to leave it to the judges or
this
what?
This one is close, Mitch. It is still anyone's bout for the taking. We are 5 minutes away from finding out who will become the interim Bantamweight World Champion. This crowd rallying behind Kevin Belingon. You had expected it. Belingon said he'd knock out the Australian.
It's gonna come down to who can throw caution to the wind, find that next level, and really start pushing the action.
Overhand right from Belingon. Jab from Ewing. Both men still look fresh as a daisy. Inside thigh kick from Belingon. Jab from the Australian. Drops level, almost takes a knee to the face from Belingon. That was nice timing for the Philippine.
It was, he's timing it correctly. It's like a striking chess match. I mean, everybody, I mean, they're trying to take risks. They're trying to... tries to back him up against the cage.
Ewan trying to close down the movement. Shoots it again. Good defense once more from Kevin Belingon. The rangefinder from the Filipino. Overhand right from Martin Ewan. Left hook from the Aussie. Goes to the body. Goes to the brick basket. There's the overhand right from Ewan. He came agonizingly close. Brooke Ewan shouting go Martin in the background. A high right roundhouse from Belingon. There's the jab. Overhand right from Belingon. Went higher than Michael Ostrom.
That sidestep, man, is beautifully done. Martin's got great movement in his eyes. That's what makes him so dangerous is his constant movement. He sees things coming and just slides out of the way.
Ewan jamming, Ewan faking, Belingon goes to the body. We've got over 2 minutes remaining. Who will become the interim Bantamweight World Champion? Jab from Ewan, jabbing well.
Belingon!
the final round. And Belingon to the inside thigh. Goes down to the body now, off the lead hand. 90 seconds on the clock.
He's evading a lot of shots.
Hunting for the image. Hunting for the overhand right. There it goes again. Hoping for the headache maker. Both men swing wildly. They are powerless elbows. They are designed to knock you out. If only they could connect. Uppercut there from Martin Ewan. Ewan shoots it for a double leg. One more for Belingon. And the takedown. Jump for Belingon. This is the best. Champion Bibiano Fernandes knows that he will probably face the winner of this sometime soon. Will it be that man Kevin Belingon from Team Lakay in Baguio City? There's the CEO and founder of One Championship, Chatri Sitjatong, to present the gold. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And now, one interim Bantamweight world champion, Kevin
He's gone 1-4 in his last five, 4-6 in his last 10. Eustaquio, 3-2 in his last five, 6-4 in his last 10. Eustaquio does possess that beautiful wushu striking. Actually began his martial arts career in kickboxing, then moved to wushu as a 14-year-old. Became a member of the national wushu team of the Philippines. Harry ties him up, hoping for a really takedown. Gets it. Has the back of Eustaquio. Not where Geje wants to be early on. 8 submissions in 11 wins for Terry Taylor for a 73% finishing run.
Not exactly the same way it happened back in 2016, but pretty close. Geje's got to be going through deja vu right about now. You can see the way Taru's trying to lace up that leg with the arm. He's trying to trap the arm with the leg, but Geje's doing a good job at defending right now. Taru's only got one hook in, but he doesn't need both hooks to finish. He can just triangle his legs and secure that position right there. The biggest danger for Geje right now is that left arm. You can see Taru's trying to slowly work it underneath the chin. He's prying the chin up, and he's trying to work on that strangle. You can see Geje's defending the right arm of Taru, not allowing him to lock the arms together. So it's very important that first he defends the choking hand, and then he can work off the other one.
Taru hunting for history to repeat itself. And here make a joke, Geje Eustaquio again. champion hasn't finished an opponent himself since January 2016 when he tied South America in the first round. Overnight, Eustaquio, two knockouts, two subs. 11-7, Jaru, eight subs. Taking his time here, 15, Tony Jaru.
He went under the right arm there of Jay Hay, so he's a little bit out of dangerous choking position. Right now, Taru is just kind of hand battling right now. So you can see Jay Hay's okay because he's defending the hands correctly. Taru might transition here to mount. Jay Hay might go belly down. Let's see what happens here if Jay Hay can defend properly. But he scrambles, he gives up the first position. Taru let the hook go. But he slowly started to work that arm underneath the chin of Jay Hay.
Full contingent of Team Lakay megastars in the house tonight. Adrian Fillon and Joshua Passio both competing later on now. Colgan and Manavent. Honorio, The Rock, the Mario, Kevin Belingon. All of them world champions and present. All here tonight. Along with coach Mark Sanjay. The amazing Team Lakay from Baghdad City. Now, Jay Hay, top position. Now, Jay Hay's turn. This crowd goes bananas! Inside the courtyard of Taru. Now the tide is turned. The knees now from Jay Hay.
Jay Hay did a good job defending, was able to free himself from that hook, and then once he was able to get rid of that hook, he was able to turn the position and end up on top position. Right now, you can see Taru starting to go high guard, trying to get nice and high on that guard so he can control the posture of Jay Hay, not allowing the posture to start punching.
The sold-out crowd inside the massive ball of Asia Arena is deafening when they pop for Jay Hay Eustaquio. You think this is deafening? Wait till you see Edward Fulai on main event. Wait till Joshua Passio comes out their main event. They go absolutely off their rockets. And Eustaquio, great go from the crowd. Can he posture up and work the ground and back? This is Eustaquio's busiest year ever. His fourth match this year, making 2019 his hottest year. Taru, 1-5 in one championship. There was a time of 3 years between 2011 and 2014 when he went to a magnificent 10-match winning streak with 7 finishes, including a Gogo Plata that got him signed to one championship. Gogo Plata. Shoulder lock. And the Plata win for the Gogo Plata against Eustaquio tonight. Will be something else. Can't see it happening. But again, you never know. Drive from Taru. Turning back to Wushu style from Eustaquio. Wushu's main weapon. Known for its cutting side kicks. To the legs, to the body. Wow, that almost took out the ring back just on the bell there from Eustaquio.
Well, we said from the beginning, Taru needed to get this match to the ground, and he did just that. Beautiful duck under there of the big left hook coming from Jay Hay. Taru was able to sneak around, get the back, control the position, and spend a couple minutes in a very dominant position until this moment where Jay Hay was able to ignite the crowd, end up inside control, work his way back into top, and then get back up onto his feet to do a little bit of his handiwork. But that was a good round for Jay Hay Eustaquio and Tony Taru, spending that much time in top position.
So many luminaries inside the Mall of Asia Arena tonight. And once again, folks, don't forget to follow us across all your social media platforms. At One Championship on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Sparkling crowd, 100% behind Jay Hay Eustaquio, former flyweight world champion.
Ready, go!
Eustaquio, who holds a master's in physical education from University of the Huilleras. The outside making from Jay Hay. A sweeter human being you will not find than Jay Hay Eustaquio. Very softly spoken. Always with a hand in the inside the ring, inside the circle. can be a monster. I see the Wushu striking coming to play again here from Eustaquio. He's beaten the likes of Johnny Silva, Alex Silva, Adriano Moraes. It is revenge on Tony Towery tonight. Hook there from Towery. Thin with the heart and the reach. One arm, long legs on Towery. Good stick jab from Eustaquio. Planting right hand. With a change here from Eustaquio, Mitch. A bit more pepper behind that. The punches now.
Yeah, he's doing a beautiful job of slipping the jab of Taru and coming in and throwing left hands of his own. And he's starting to touch Taru a lot. There's a lot of significant strikes landed. And now he's starting to put the right hand behind that left hand. And he's starting to really add up the combinations.
Taru would like to put hands on Eustaquio, take him down, get on top, or maybe even take Jahez back. Tried for a tough finish there, couldn't get the knees up though, Tony Taru. Good jab from Eustaquio, snaking it through the guard of the fin. Overhand right to left hook, nothing but air. Double jab, Eustaquio. Outside knee kick, slung it in. Hitting the top of the quadriceps of Taru. Taru edges forward. If you're going to throw the jab, got to throw the right hand for company here, Tony. Eustaquio, chin tucked, looking through his brow. Uppercut to left hook. Left hook again with a bit of a skip in there from Eustaquio. Want to see the kicks now from Eustaquio. Underneath, the leg kicks, the side kicks. There it is, must have heard me. This has been a good round for Eustaquio with the striking and another big leg kick just above the knee for that coronal nerve. Aru's got to start answering back. Eustaquio circling into the power side, showing no respect for the right side power of Tony Taru. 3 minutes five remains, second of three.
Eustaquio's doing a beautiful job of slipping these punches. He's really got a good read on exactly what Taru's going to be doing, and he's able to slide effortlessly out the way and then land beautiful shots like that. I like how he started tapping the legs, too. He's starting to sweep out the legs and really start to take out the base of Taru. But this is what Taru wanted. Oh, beautiful little kick out there. And Eustaquio to get back up to his feet.
Okay, from Eustaquio, he may have made a sloppy mistake moments earlier. Trying to knock the beard off. Leg kick. Turning back kick. Oh, Eustaquio pulling out the full arsenal of Wushu striking. Amazing crowd here. Sounds like a football arena. We're all cheering on Geje Eustaquio. Dances. He's giving them a show. Aru needs to find a way to get Geje to ground again in the first round. But Geje would like to get back in world title contention in 2020. A former world champion. 35 seconds on the clock, second round of three. Maybe a welcome return to his corner for Taru.
Surprised I'm not seeing any takedowns. Like, he's not really shooting in for these takedowns. Because right now, this is what he does. He likes to back Geje up. There's a possibility he's choosing to exchange. He likes the striking so much, but he's just getting outworked just by a beat. You can just see that Geje is just one step ahead of him. Geje's looking into that crystal ball and knows exactly what Taru's going to throw.
Geje delighting the crowd right at the end of the second round. And that is now 5 minutes remaining. Lunas sold out inside the massive Mall of Asia Arena. What a sight! What a spectacle! It's one championship.
It's Just a master class right now thrown by Geje. Look at that, beautiful. Caught the jumping front kick, swept out the other leg. He thought about entering Taru's guard. He's like, nah, that's your game, not mine. Get back up, let me touch you up some more. And then he starts working on the feet again. I like the way he's throwing that left hand. He's throwing it from all kinds of angles, uppercuts, hooks, and jabs. I'd like to see this round, he starts putting on the kicks behind that left hand. Throw the hand combination, go after the legs, go after the body, ultimately maybe go way up top, go head hunting up in the skyscraper and try to take out the fin.
Third and final round between Tony Taru and Geje Eustaquio. Repeat or revenge. If you're scoring round by round, it may very well be one of his. This is scored as an overall contest. Chance go up for Geje Eustaquio again. Philippine fans love it, and he delivers on the wushu. Off a loss last time out by a knockout to Yuya Wakamatsu on August 2nd. Eustaquio, a 34% finishing rate. Taru, 73%. That's a new kick from Eustaquio. Fourth match of 2019, his busiest year to date. The next match time is now 16 bouts, 14 minutes and 13 seconds. Taru's average match time is now 12 outings, 8 minutes, 25 seconds.
Now we're starting to see more kicks from Geje. He's starting to go inside, outside on the leg kicks, slowing down the movement of Taru, get him a little bit more stationary so he can start landing some bigger weapons, like this strategy change in the third and final.
How it goes, buddy, then goes man. He's able to get into the rebound in the first place. Up again. Tries to put the chin through the top of the head. Another up again, followed by a lead hand. Jab two from Geje, follows with a left hook. Checked off of Taru, tries to pull the head down, and Geje Eustaquio, good jab from the field.
Taru's got decent hand combinations. He's doing well. I like the shoulder roll he's trying to implement. But he's just getting touched too much. When Geje's entering into these strikes, he's kind of old. He's not really overcommitting, so he's not giving Taru the opportunity to duck under for the double leg. Very smart, strategic game plan being executed by Eustaquio.
How nice is Eustaquio's turning back kick to the gut. Let's see if he does it again. There's that little section. River about the size of that. Goes for it, he gets it. That's the little knockout. That's the one I spoke about. It's good night, Irene. Forget about it. Sign the pink slip, sign the ownership papers. A turning back kick to the liver. And it's good night for Tony Taru. That was awesome.
That was an impressive back kick, but the fact that you picked it up about 15 seconds, I don't know if the fans at home caught that. Michael Cervello calling his shot. That was beautifully done. He went for it, caught him on the side. Taru crumpled. Beautifully done.
There is no more painful way in combat sports, folks, to get knocked out than a liver shot. And that's exactly what you saw there from Geje Eustaquio. A perfectly placed shot to the liver. It's a moment's delayed reaction. You impact the vagus nerve. You strike between the 9th and 10th ribs. Down you go, and there's no chance of getting up.
Look at that pinpoint accuracy. Cervello saw it. Tony Taru did not. The beautifully done heel right to the liver. The whole body shuts down.
He knew it was over.
That's high-level striking. That's experience out there. When you drop somebody, you let him off the hook. That's called a walk-off knockout, ladies and gentlemen. Beautifully done.
You will not find a better liver kick than that. Impacting that liver, closing down the entire body. That one would have made Bas Rutten proud. His crowd loving it. Big win for Eustaquio to end the year. Big win for the Philippines. Huge win for Team Lakay. Let's get a Tom Lau.
To present the medal for this match, we have Vice President for Hotels and Food and Beverage of City of Dreams, Manila, Mr. Michael Zimmer. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kemp Cheng, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 11 seconds in the third round for your winner by way of knockout, Geje Eustaquio.
Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chosimukia, Belingon in the red, Fernandes in the black. It may very well be the raw power of Belingon, the finesse and technique of Bibiano Fernandes.
You see Kevin throwing that lead hook. That's how he sets up that spinning kick. He's looking for the spin early. Bibiano testing the leg right there.
We saw the turning back kick to the liver of Andrew Leone. One of the most spectacular kicks we've ever seen. It sent Leone a full 10 feet across the ring on that night. Was the beginning of the end for Leone. And there it is from Belingon. Turning back kick to the liver.
That's one to the body already.
Jab from Belingon, outside fly kick from Bibiano, looking to drop down for a single leg there, the Brazilian. Belingon saying he received a groin strike, and a moment's break here called by referee Olivier Cox.
You can hear the
certainly the aggressive start though from Kevin Belingon here, Mitch. He's turning early, he's trying to line up the power salvo.
As we said, he wanted to attack the body. This is the exchange. Bibiano went low right there as he was attempting an inside leg kick. Yes, he went back up, a flurry of punches. He was looking for the takedown. Takedown wasn't there. It came over the top. Did tap the groin.
Just a caution there from our referee, Olivier Ghost. Accidental groin strike, of course, but you hit the groin and the pain receptors kick in. So a moment to recover here for Kevin Belingon, who's already showing his hand very early on in this world title match. We can see the game plan here of Kevin, as you said, to go to the body of Bibiano Fernandes. They believe that's the weakness. They believe that's the chink in the armor of Bibiano Fernandes.
This is how he likes to set up, right there to the low, right there. No denying that it happened. You can almost hear the crack going right there. But Bibiano shakes it off, being the pro that he is, ready to put in work.
They recommence here in the first round of action. Look for the body work again from Belingon, the man with the flowing mullet. Fernandes, the bantamweight champion, the greatest champion in ONE history. Never beaten here in ONE.
Bibiano's got that reach advantage. Let's see him throw out that jab, start testing the distance.
Oh, he just put Bibi on the jaw with that short left hand. Bibi dropping low levels to try and lock onto a leg to take down Belingon. Belingon does not want to go to the ground with Fernandes. Fernandes, double leg here, trying to get the Filipino down. Belingon not going there, however. Body shot from Belingon.
This would be a good first test for Kevin Belingon's takedown defense. He looked stellar against Martin Nguyen in the takedown defense, but Bibiano is a different breed of grappler. Look at him attacking the legs. Look at Kevin. Good defense so far. He's got to be careful. That's where you want to go.
Inside of half guard here. Bibi Fernandes, top position, peppering palm strikes to the side of the head of Kevin Belingon. Now Belingon finds himself in Bibi land. How do they defend against the several submission attempts and the ground and pound that Bibi can bring from these positions?
First thing he needs to do is take that right arm and start looking for an underhook. In half guard position, if he can get an underhook underneath the left arm of Bibiano, he's going to be able to turn onto his side. Now he's got the arms trapped on the other side, so he's got the half guard on the other side. That's what he needs to start doing. He needs to get one side on the underhook, because right now he's got his half guard on the left leg of Bibiano and the underhook on the other side, the right side of Bibiano. So he's kind of trapped himself in this position. Bibiano can apply pressure with his shoulder and look to pass the guard.
Watch out,
needs to create movement in this space. It doesn't want to give Bibiano the opportunity to start setting things up.
Fernandes, a BJJ sensation, five-time world champion, three-time Pan-American champion, has won 11 gold medals in elite BJJ competitions around the world. It's been an aggressive start from Bibi. Fernandes has a proven gas tank. He's gone five rounds, five times in his career, winning all five times by decision.
No technique on the escape right there. Pure explosion to get out of the half guard there, Bibiano Fernandes.
Three sets here. This Belingon has power in the legs. Oh, turning back kick to the liver. And there's one to the head. He tries to take his head off. The headache maker for Belingon. He's put the power early. And Fernandes looked a little shocked momentarily. Especially the spinning hook kick to the head. There's another turning back kick to the liver.
He was right. They are definitely going after the body with that spinning back kick. And look how fast he comes out of that. There's almost no setup. He's not even throwing that hook. It's just an explosion into that turning back kick.
The liver, a very large organ in the upper right portion of the abdomen. Highly vascular area. A shot to the liver can be excruciatingly painful. Martial articles say the most painful way to get knocked out is with a liver shot. Turning back to the liver again there from Belingon. It's about the size of a football, the liver, right side of the body. Mostly protected by the rib cage, but still slightly exposed. And if you dig in between the 9th and 10th rib, you hit that vagus nerve, it can close down the entire body. That's what Belingon's looking to do with his turning back kick. There's one from Bibi Fernandes. But my word, what a start here from Kevin Belingon. He went straight to the game plan. He showed his hand. There's the new VP, Misha Tate. There's Mighty Mouse, Demetrius Johnson. So many luminaries here, cage-side in Singapore for one championship.
This is what they're watching. That was spinning back kick landed, not close to the liver, but up top a little bit. That one was hunting again after it. He is repeatedly going after that. But that up top kick was a beautiful spinning heel kick. Caught Bibiano high on the guard, veteran that he is, caught that.
Okay, Mitch, play coach for a moment. If you're Team Lakay, what are you telling Kevin Belingon to do?
Kevin Belingon is putting things together beautifully right now. Their game plan is working to the T. I'd like to see Kevin Belingon set that up a little bit, throw the jab, get him thinking about the hands first, get Bibiano to lift his hands up, then spin the attack to the body. Bibiano, he's got to move forward. He's a little bit tentative there in the last couple, about 90 seconds of that first round. He started to slow down a bit. He was watching careful to the body.
Ready?
Likes to Bibiano throw the hands and start to chain wrestle with him. Back Kevin up against the cage and take him down and grind on him.
Singapore has been a happy hunting ground for Bibiano Fernandes. It was here in 2013 that he won the title. Well, to unify the one bantamweight world title by Benny Suchul Kim. A good right hand stiffly there from Belingon. Bibi tries to thread the right hook, turning back into the liver. Bibi backs it up with the right hand. Double leg down from the Brazilian. Gets the takedown, and we're back in Bibi land. The half guard position. Let's see what Fernandes can do. The takedown has come early in the second round.
And we were set up with the hands. He was able to utilize the boxing, back Kevin up with the big right hand, get him up against the cage, and now he's grinding on him. Now Bibiano's going to start to slowly and methodically work on Kevin. He's got to slow him down a little bit. He's got to get Kevin to expend some energy. Kevin is extremely explosive. That's how he got out of the first exchange here on the ground. He was able to just throw Bibi off on him.
Let's go, guys.
The explosion, the fast twitch muscle fiber of Kevin Belingon is at an all-time high. Bibiano needs to slow him down.
It's got to serve well mentally for Kevin Belingon that he's out of the first round. Last time they met in 2016, Bibiano tapped out Belingon with a kimura in just 4 minutes and 4 seconds. Here he is in the second round, and Belingon told us, I'm a completely different martial arts machine than I was last time we fought.
Every single one of Team Lakay always excels in the rematch. They go back, they've got their head coach who breaks everything down, and they always find a way to be much more successful in the second time
around. Fence, fence, fence.
When they run it back, Team Lakay, second team.
Now we're on 19 and 5, 11 finishes, including 8 knockouts, 9 of those in the very first round. Scramble here. Belingon back to his feet. Seems to be overwhelming Filipino support for Kevin Belingon in the crowd here in Singapore tonight.
And again, he exploded out of the technique.
And the chants go up for Kevin Belingon, the underdog here in Singapore. And Belingon gets out of the way. What a matchup for the Bantamweight Championship of the World. It's one championship, Heart of the Lion, live from the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Got the right hand cocked and ready here, Belingon. Shifts off to his left. Phoebe did center the cage. Jab there from Fernandes. Belingon taking his time. Very patient match so far from Belingon. Overhand right misses.
Everything Kevin throws is full force. There's no waiting out process, no setup. Everything is just one big shot trying to take that head off of Bibiano Fernandes. But good eyes from the veteran. He's moving out well. And so Kevin is extending.
Oh, my word! He got an jump turning back kick to the belly button of Bibiano Fernandes. He must have been half a foot off the ground, Mick. That was incredible.
You hear the crash from that side kick.
Tucked down there from Fernandes. Now the Brazilian up the intensity, up the aggression. Takes the back of Belingon. Here's Bibiano. This is what Fernandes does so well. The body triangle locked on. And Belingon's got no place to go. Belingon could be in trouble here. Bibiano goes for the arm,
Kevin Belingon pushed the leg off of Bibiano. A straight escape through the arm off, or through the leg off rather, saved the arm, but Bibiano still can't even accept the arm off. Bibiano is covered up. A lot of this is coming off. Those landed right there, though. Bibiano's laughing. He's okay.
Have a look at Belingon. It's a meltdown in Singapore.
Bibiano's still attacking off his back. Threw up an armbar attempt right there. Now he's got the high guard. Look for him to go for a triangle. He's got one arm trapped there on the side. He's going to let it go. He's still got the arm trapped. Looking for the armbar.
Belingon gets up some shots. That's two yards down. This one is an absolute rip starter.
Kevin, he survived the back. Look at Bibby. Look at the way he's trapped that right left arm. Throws the leg over. Look at Kevin. Get off me. Get that leg off me. He's okay. I'm okay. Get that leg off. Bibiano covers back up. Still has that arm trapped. Look how he traps the arm with his leg. Hooks in like he's doing a hamstring curl. Completely has the arm trapped. Uses his right arm to attempt it again. Goes after it again. Kevin shrugs him off. Gets on top and drops the ground and pound. What a second round, Michael Ciavello.
Kevin Belingon, more escapes than Michael Schofield in that round. And what have we got in store for you in the third? It's an absolute barn burner. Belingon first to emerge from his stall. Third round of five. We are heading towards that deep water. Bibiano's been there many times before. And this sellout crowd here in Singapore, loving every moment of a truly epic main event. Let's see if Belingon goes back to that river with the turning Wushu back kick. Belingon begins martial arts career in Wushu. Was awarded a Wushu scholarship to the University of Encordilleras. Led his move to Baguio City. And then, of course, joined the great Team Lakay. Here's a Philippines national Wushu champion. And we've been seeing some of that Wushu striking. Belingon just falling short with that right hand. overhand right there. Here's the training button for the midsection, trying to put the belly button through the back. BB measuring with the jab, resets now. Good right hand lead there from Fernandes.
The reach of Bibiano is, that's what makes him so effective on the stand-up. He just utilizes that reach so very well. You can see Kevin throws big, wide, looping shots. You can see how his elbows are nice and flared. That leaves a hole right through the middle. Bibiano's trying to exemplify, he's trying to exploit it, but Kevin is throwing everything with still 100% power.
His main sparring and training partner, Mighty Mouse Demetrius Johnson here at cage side. Bibiano Fernandes going for title defense number 10. Mighty Mouse has had 11 of them. Two amazing, complete martial arts warriors. Bibiano Fernandes finding himself right now in the match of his life. The crowd in Singapore against him. Kevin Belingon has brought the heat from the opening bell. We saw the flash of Bibiano, the flash of the flash Fernandes in the second round when he came agonizingly close to taking home Kevin's arm.
And very close, but Kevin came just as close to going with the body. Those shots are going to start to pay dividends later in the match. Going to start to wear down Bibiano. Bibiano is not as fast as slow, but he's still landing with these shots.
There's a jab two from Bibiano, left to go from Belingon. 2 minutes 40 remains, third round of five. The Philippines versus Brazil. Almost caught him with the counter right hand there. And a snappy jab from Belingon. But Bibiano had the right idea when Belingon commits that turning back into the liver and he misses the target, the follow, the counter right hand could come smack bang on the kisser.
And where have we seen that before?
To Newman, give it to Edward Filayan.
That could be the answer to that little riddle right there. Edward's shown his hand, he says, I'm gonna spin. Bibiano has gotta circle out to the side and land that hand over right hand he's got.
Mitch, at any point here, do you feel that Belingon is going to the well one time too many, hunting after that turning back into the liver, that it may become predictable and BB may start to really time off it?
He's probably up near the double digits in attempting that spin kick. Bibiano's seen it, but he's got to avoid it. He can't take it over and over again. He's going to start to wear on him. And Kevin is throwing everything with full power. So you can see Kevin starting to slow down too. And this is his crowd.
Going to get a 1 minute 40 remains, 35.
Interesting. Bibiano could have went into side control, but he chose to shove the legs between his legs, trap him, and slowly try to work his way into mount.
Let's go, guys, work!
A tremendous contest. Right in front of our Chinese commentary team across the cage there.
In the
top position, Kevin Belingon. Hope you enjoy the place
here
live in 138 countries, all live and free on the One Super App as Bibi Fernandes mounts Kevin Belingon.
And Belingon's got 45 seconds here. He's got to hold on tight to those arms, but now they're starting to be sweaty, so Bibiano slid the arm out. Now he's going to go. Look how he has that left arm there. He's nice and high. Kevin's got to pull him tight. It's a bad spot to be in, though. This sets up an armbar. Watch his knees. If he chooses to go high, oh, he goes flat. Applies the pressure there. Now he's. I think this is a ground and pound position right now.
20 seconds remains. Third round.
That's the veteran right there, Bibiano. He knows that they're slippery right now, so Kevin could pull out of an armbar. So he chose to go heavy hits and soften him up and end the round in a very dominant position.
Postures up now, Fernandes tries to drop the angles on the head of Belingon. Sneaks in the right hand, three down, two to go.
That's a veteran move right there. He chose to not risk losing the position by going after the armbar. He flattened his hips out, softened Kevin up a little bit, went high right as the bell was about to ring, and just let the punches come down. And that, you don't go round by round, we go by the match in its entirety, but that is a great way to end 15 minutes right there, Mr. Shabello.
Star-studded Team Lakay. the trainer of Kevin Belingon. The last man, Edward Goliath, who in a few weeks' time in Manila will take on Amir Khan for the World Lightweight Championship. There's Bibiano Fernandes. You know he's seen it all before.
Fast and hard.
Do you feel that Fernandes underestimated Belingon at all, Mitch?
No, I don't think so. I think he's seen the past six matches. I think he's seen the improvements that Kevin's made, but he's also extremely confident in himself, and he knows the type of martial artist that he is, the type of athlete that he is, and also the type of strategist that he is. Everything that he's doing is very methodical at this point. These are the championship rounds. This is where Bibiano lives and breathes.
Let's go, guys.
The penultimate round. Jab in from Belingon. Jab from Bibiano Fernandes. Spinning heel kick from Belingon. Coming close. Try to bring the heel to the temple. Cutting Wushu's side kick to the knee there. Common Polonia move just above the knee. Jab from Belingon to put down the points. Fernandes jab two, didn't have the stops behind it though.
And he's still landing on Kevin. And that's what's giving him a little bit of just success in the stand-up, is he still landing with these shots. And what that's gonna do, it's gonna create an opening for him to just like that, throw that overhand right, change levels, and go after those legs.
Two absolute warriors who have overcome a lot of adversity early on in life. Fernandes almost dying from malaria, contracted in the Amazon jungle where he was fending for himself and hunting and gathering as a seven-year-old. Belingon had to go through some loss of family members, raiding of bandits in his childhood home in the Philippines, abject poverty. And here they are, both men, in the main event to the top of the martial arts world. Championship here in Singapore.
Up to finish.
Jumped over the half guard there, landed inside control. Kevin starts to look a little bit fatigued. This is not something we're used to seeing. That's that explosion that we're talking about. You can't explode out of like that. You have to make sure you're technical. You still got to maintain that technique, especially with a grappler like Bibiano Fernandes.
Once again, we are in the deep theater. As I said earlier, Fernandes, five times his career, has gone the full five rounds, won all of those decisions.
Up to finish.
Doesn't look like Belingon's gas tank is slowing at all, even though he is the older statesman here. Side control for the Brazilian. 2 minutes 35 remaining, fourth of five. The Bantamweight Championship of the World. Oh, elbow to the top of the head there from Belingon, trying to open up a cut perhaps. Cuts in the hip a little here from side control to Fernandes. The media attention surrounding this main event all week here in Singapore. It's been extraordinary. So many photographers and reporters from newspaper, radio, television, websites. Some groundbreaking news released in one championship this week.
Let's go, one to finish.
And we are seeing a fitting main event. Looks for the full mouth as Fernandes slips out the back. He tries to take the arm. And once again, Belingon is free. And this crowd loves it. Another escape from Belingon.
Hard to finish an arm bar this late in the match. They're so slippery, easy for them to pull out. But Bibiano, once he gets a hold of that arm, he can stay tight with it. But Kevin is still so explosive, he's able to just power out of these shots. Or these attempts at submissions.
1:25 on the clock now. Bibiano's gotten Belingon to deep water. You see that the aggressive striking is not fair as it was in the opening two rounds from Belingon. It's still dangerous as ever. Is it demoralizing, Mitch, that Bibby's trying to dumb last and securing them?
Not so much. I don't think he's demoralized. I think he's trying to figure out another solution. You can see him inside the side control, and and he didn't want to give it up, but he's trying to finish. Bibiano is not the lay and pray. He's not going to stay there and just hold the position. He's going to try to finish you. He loves to finish his opponents, and he's always going to be looking for it. He made that as a calculated risk. It didn't pay off, but that's Bibiano Fernandes for you.
Fernandes controlling since
30 seconds left in the fourth round.
Undefeated since 2010, Bibiano Fernandes. And what great rounds he's picked along the way. Antonio Banuelos, Yoshiro Maeda, Koichi Okazaki, Sutro Kim, Ueda, Daehwan Kim, Tony Taru, Chris McCullough. There's damage on the bridge of the nose of Bibi Fernandes. Another top thumping right hand into the round. We're going into the fifth and final. This is crazy.
That's the power of the silencer. Out of nowhere, the tide can change. He put Bibiano on his backside with that beautiful right hand. Look at Bibiano, measuring, calculating, right through the middle with the right hand. Watch Kevin Belingon using that power to slip his way out. The BJJ World Champion goes after the submission, has the armbar deep. Look at Kevin, no, not today. This is my moment to shine. Beautifully done, but what does Kevin still have? He still has that power in his right hand. The thunder in the right hand can be delivered at any moment. He's still dangerous. Still, even though he's tired, even though he's exhausted, he still has that one-hitter critter, Michael.
5th and final round. 99% of pundits did not think it would get this far. But here we are, inside the sold-out Singapore Indoor Stadium for the Bantamweight Championship of the World. Who will prevail? They touch gloves. Outside knee kick from Fernandes, the champion. Outside knee kick again. What tremendous heart. What aggression, what power from the interim champion, Kevin Belingon. Turning back kick to the liver from Belingon. All right, Mitch, with 4 minutes 30 remaining, what does Belingon need to do?
He's gonna have to land big. He's attacking that leg beautifully. See how Bibiano's limping a little bit on that leg? I think these things are starting to build up for him. But what's he doing? He's setting up that spinning back kick. He's gonna keep going to the well. He's gonna keep looking for that power. What it's gonna do is gonna get Bibiano to drop his elbows down to his body to protect the body shot. What's that gonna do? That's gonna open up the head. Kevin Belingon can still come over the top with a beautiful right hand. Bibiano needs to work the jab. Needs to work the jab, set up that right hand, and look for the takedown. Put Kevin on his back and grind on him for the next 4 minutes. But he's got to get at least 2 minutes on the ground in a dominant position.
Time is ticking down. Fernandes sends a cut. Inside leg kick to the right hand. Good combination, Fernandes. Jab there from Belingon. Belingon looks for the outside lead leg. Can't find it. Lots of swelling around the brow of Kevin Belingon. Damage to the bridge of the nose of Bibiano Fernandes. High kick from Belingon. Fernandes saw that one coming. Jump turning back kick. Bon Jovi star. Shot to the heart. Bibi resets. Will one of these two men put their foot down and go for it? Throw caution to the wind. Hell for leather with 3 minutes remaining. Is it time to pull out all the stops? Leg kick there from Belingon. And goes to the inside thigh.
Michael, at 20 minutes, I had Bibiano slightly ahead, even though he was knocked down by that right hand. But at this point, Kevin is starting to inch forward. He's starting to land these strikes. He's starting to outstrike Bibiano Fernandes. He's starting to connect more.
You wonder if with his experience, Bibiano may be trying to go kleptomaniac and steal them in the final minute or so. Jab from Belingon. This one's close. There's no doubt about it. It could turn any moment.
This is an extremely close match. I think it might come down to the last 2 minutes. Either way, Right now, Kevin's starting to find his rhythm. He's starting to land shots. Bibiano found his right home for that right hand just now.
Inside leg kick from Belingon, nice and high on that inside thigh.
There's a scoring, Michael. That's like the fifth one that's landed this round.
Belingon has been putting down the score with the striking here in the fifth. Bibi's got to change it up now. Got to go for something, either the strikes or look for that takedown. Jabs from both men.
I think he needs a takedown. He doesn't want to stand here with Kevin lighting him up. That's what he goes after. Oh, Kevin gets away from Bibiano Fernandes. Can he do that for another 90 seconds to keep on his feet? Keep going after that low inside leg kick.
Kevin Belingon, a man who likes to raise chickens. Looked like a greased chicken as he escaped Bibiano Fernandes moments ago. Chance went up for Bellingham. Big outside fight here from Fernandes. There's 1 minute 10 remaining for the Bantamweight Championship of the World. Leg kick again from Bellingham. No doubt he's won the striking in this final round. Jab to Bibiano. What does Fernandes have left? He tries to catch him, but it's not catching greased lightning.
He's got to set that up better. He's got to throw those hands. He's got to get Kevin lifting up his hands to protect the head and then shoot him for the takedown. Nice leg kick.
Capture off a leg kick with the right hand from Belingon. Threads the jab, does Bibiano Fernandes. Under 40 seconds now. Leg kicks again from Belingon.
30 seconds left in the final.
This is Belingon's world, man.
And the target prep for Belingon. On the back foot and out striking Fernandes. Fernandes has come forward. Belingon misses with a little gap. 15 seconds now. Is there one big salvo left? Is there a Hail Mary shot? Final 10 seconds. This place going crazy. Belingon puts a fist in the air. He believes he's won it. And there it is.
Michael Cervello, what back and forth action. Every round was razor close. So many different variables go into judging this matchup. The striking superiority of Kevin Belingon, the shots landed by Bibiano Fernandes, the top control, the submission attempts. What an amazing unification bout between two world-class martial artists, two Bantamweight World Champions. Who is going to leave Singapore with the strap? Michael Cervello.
Chatri Sinjitong, the founder of One Championship, to present the belt to the winner. Will it be Kevin Belingon? Will it be Bibiano Fernandes? Wherever you're watching live in 138 countries, live and free on the One Super app, how do you score it? Belingon claim his 20th career victory. Does Fernandes get his 23rd? Does Belingon stop the streak of Fernandes, the winning streak that dates back to 2011? Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this bout in favor of the red corner. Judge number two scores this bout in favor of the blue corner. And judge number three calls this bout in favor of your winner by split decision. And now, the undisputed one bantamweight champion of the world, Kevin Belingon!
Brought to you by Studio City, Asia's entertainment capital. Michael Cervello, Mitch Chilson with you. Moraes has the length, has the height. Eustaquio striking has improved out of sight in recent times. But how does the memory linger of being choked out 4 years ago in the second round? Eustaquio, though, has never lost a rematch, Mitch.
You know, and he's just gotten better and better every single time he steps into the cage, or the ring in this case. He says he's looking forward to being in the ring. He wants to utilize the ring's just dimensions and really start to confuse Moraes on the feet.
Moraes moving well early on, high on the balls of his feet. There's a high-lift roundhouse kick from the Brazilian. Eustaquio, Wushu competitor. Multiple Wushu champion, over 30 Wushu wins. Let's see if the striking comes into play. Moraes, four-time BJJ state champion, BJJ black belt under Ataedi Jr. His 11th appearance here in one championship, 8-2 in the promotion for the champ. Just feeling out process. Outside leg kick, Eustaquio, tipping body shot from Moraes. Moraes also wins over Karadak Matop, Eugene Takiro, Rico Shibuya, Danny Kingan. Eustaquio goes for the inside lead fly. Eustaquio has also beaten Akhmatov, Bunra, Gianni Silva, Saiful Mirikin, Alex Silva. Never been stopped by strikes. Show how Eustaquio got a phenomenal gas tank as well. He did say he'll try and draw Moraes into deep water. Believes he'll decision Adriano Moraes tonight.
Nice little lead roundhouse there from Eustaquio.
A glorified kickboxing contest so far. Makes some feints here from the champion, switching stance, Adriano Moraes.
Look at Eustaquio going for the takedown, but caught in the arm there of the choke master.
Doesn't want to be there. He was there 4 years ago, a guillotine choke attempt from Moraes.
It's kind of tough to finish with one arm, if not pretty much impossible, but Eustaquio trying to work his way around the side, past the guard there of Moraes.
Go grab the shot, go grab the shot.
Look at Moraes consistently adjusting like a boa constrictor, finding the perfect angle for that choke to get in.
Not where Eustaquio wants to be against the champion this early in the contest. Tight close guard here, but Eustaquio gives Olivier Costa the thumbs up.
See, Moraes is starting to adjust. He's inching forward. Geje's got to plant his head into the ground and protect the neck. Then he starts the hand fight. He's got to start going after those hands to break that grip.
Moraes, is he expending his own energy and looking for this submission for so long, Mitch?
Man, when you've been doing Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu as long as Adriano Moraes has, it's going to take a lot more than a two-minute guillotine attempt to gas out your arms.
Is this dangerous for Eustaquio? How much of this guillotine? Oh, he's going to put the head up.
That answers that question.
But he's still stuck inside the closed guard here.
Boss is going to slide him around.
All right, ready? Chop.
1 minute left.
What does Geje need to do here, Mitch?
Well, you might want to start posturing up and just start letting go of little short strikes. Drop the elbow, get back in, avoid, you know, any possible submission attempt from Moraes. It's going to be tough for Geje to start passing the guard and the side control and mount. Maybe not tough, but it's going to be hard without dropping a lot of punches and doing some damage to Moraes. Moraes is a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt and very skilled on the ground.
Close guard still here from Moraes. Geje would love to posture up and work some of those high fist strikes, get the ground and pound happening. Little popping punches, there's a nice elbow. Armbar!
Geje's got to stack him. He's got to be careful. He can't let Moraes start to extend the body.
He's trying to pound his way out of this predicament, and he's out of there, Eustaquio! Balancing back, tries to reach him to the canvas, the high knee! The high knee! What a way to end the opening round!
Look at that.
He flooded him up with a high knee!
Look at Geje bringing it to Macau. Sends the champion back to his stool with a bloody nose. Actually, they're both champions, but look at Geje.
going after the takedown, not scared of the ground game of Moraes, doing a little bit of damage there. Moraes was attempting the armbar, but Geje stacked him and dropped elbows to get his way out of it. Ooh, good round, good round.
Fantastic round. Moraes in control for most of it. The final flurry from Geje Eustaquio damaging the world champion. You can tell him Jay had to do in the second round, Mitch.
I like what he was doing before. He was very patient and calm on his feet. You can hear the crowd starting to get a little bit anxious, but Jay was very relaxed on his feet. I like what he was doing in the guard. Not scared to take Moraes down, to put him on his back, showing he is legit on the ground.
Second round set for five. They bound out of their respective corners. Both men trade punches early on.
Eyes on Geje, just moving slightly out of the way with that head. His eyes are so quick.
Fakes and feints again from Moraes, the larger of the two here. Eustaquio resets. Jab, no right hand for company, though, from Adriano Moraes.
Moraes has got to touch him with something. Throw that inside leg kick, you know, start putting out that jab. There's a right hand. That touched Geje.
Eustaquio also needs to capitalize while this contest is on the feet, Nick. On paper, Geje would have the striking advantage over Moraes, but on the ground, it's Moraes' world.
But Jay's a high-level striker, and he kind of takes time to get used to people's rhythm and their distance. So all you can see him doing is just sort of figuring out Moraes. Yes, he does want to keep it on his feet, but he's figuring out exactly the distance and the timing of Moraes so that he can start landing strikes later in the match.
How do you see the difference in Geje now to what it was 4 years ago when they first met?
Immensely, just to see the confidence of Geje to put Moraes on his back, not be scared of the guard, completely relaxed to give the referee a thumbs up inside the choke, just to let him know that he's okay. That just goes to show you the mindset of Geje.
Moraes coming forward, had some damage done by a high knee late in the first round, shoots in for a takedown. Well defended by Eustaquio. There's one of those great improvements.
Very good stuff of the takedown from Geje.
How about Adriano Moraes? What changes from 4 years ago, Mitch?
Well, at this point, the match was almost over. So Moraes ended it in the second round with a choke. But now we're seeing, we want to see a little bit more of a feeling out process for, you know, we're still seeing that feeling out process for Moraes. Moraes needs to put a little bit of heat on him. Utilize the angle, start putting pressure on Moraes, on Geje. Start landing that big right hand, throw some low kicks.
Big left hook there from Geje Eustaquio. Now he's starting to load up the heavy artillery. Thought about going to the body. Goes up to the jaw of Moraes. He's giving him a taste of the punch, giving him a taste of the kicks. Defense again from Geje Eustaquio.
Good job, but he's got the leg sucked in. Now he's transitioning to a single leg. Let's see if Moraes elevates him, elevates that leg, goes after the body. Good chain wrestling. Now he's got the back.
Now it's back here from Moraes. The crowd, the passionate Filipinos in their thousands behind Geje Eustaquio.
Look for Geje to explode and spin. He's going to try to separate the grip a little bit. You can see him pushing on the hands there. Moraes got one hook in, so he's got a little bit of security. See how he's grapevine that leg right there?
Referee Olivia Costa on top of the action. No takedowns successful for Moraes here in the second round thus far.
Now Moraes transitions to the other leg to get that hook in. Geje's doing a good job of defending by trying to put his back up against the ring post, but Moraes goes airborne. Try to lock in that second hook here. It's a bad spot for Geje.
In the corner, Adriano Moraes, second round 4 years ago. It's where it ended with the guillotine choke.
Did you see that? He jumped off the ring rope to catapult himself onto the back, and now he's got body triangle. It's a bad spot for Geje.
A very bad spot. The body triangle is going to restrict the breathing of Geje Eustaquio. Make it hard to get a full lung of air.
But he's almost got, he's on the side now. Geje may be able to spin, but he's got such a tight squeeze on that body triangle. Very hard for Geje to do anything.
If Eustaquio gets out of the second round, it's further than he's ever been with Moraes. Moraes going to try and set a choke.
Arms cutting under. Jehe's got to protect that neck. He's got to hold those arms, make sure nothing gets through. But good job of Moraes by softening up Geje.
20 seconds remaining. Can Moraes find a choke? Geje defending. Gives a thumbs up to referee Olivia Costa again. We are going to see the next round here. Moraes will not finish Eustaquio. And they'll start from a striking position in the next stanza. What a contest! Wherever you're watching, around the world in 138 countries, we hope you're loving One Championship Pinnacle of Power live from Studio City, sold out in Macau, China.
Interesting exchanges so far. Geje was doing a little bit of damage on his feet there. The round was his until Moraes was able to backpack. Geje utilized that body triangle, grapevine that leg, drop a little bit of ground and pound. Now they're not gonna give him a near submission on that, but that is definitely ground control, even though it's not on the ground.
Look very relaxed. They got the same edge in the Team Lakay corner.
They're just oozing confidence. They just, you can see seconds that in every out, single one of them. They're improving so much seconds in every out, area.
Third round of five in this World Championship main event in Macau, China. The champ, Adriano Moraes. The interim champ, Geje Eustaquio.
Now Moraes needs to kind of dictate this match on the feet. Right now, he's got to start putting out that jab, utilizing those low kicks.
Nice just jab like that. Too. Off the bell from the champ, and another jab too. Close to the body. Nice change of levels.
Geje, oh, nice counter there. Goes right up to the hook. Moraes putting out that jab still. At least put something in Jehe's face. And the leg kicks.
A kickboxing contest again here in the third round. Both men trade jabs, looping body shot off the lead hand there from Eustaquio.
Is the
jab from the Filipino.
Is the momentum starting to shift to Moraes' favor?
I don't see it so far, but Geje said he would increase the pace as the rounds go on. I want to see that happen from Eustaquio.
Geje looked annoyed almost at the attempt at a spinning back fist.
Outside leg kick, a nice one from the Wushu stylist. Eustaquio's got to get a move on in the striking. That is where he should be dominating Moraes. I feel he's holding back a little too much though, Mitch.
Now he's got that single leg. Now Moraes, good job by Geje to get him back up to a standing clinch. Moraes spin him around, look for him to change levels.
Taking turns on being put against the ropes here. 3:30 remains in the third of five.
But as long as Geje has those arms underneath, it's hard for Moraes to drop down and change levels.
Geje looking for the elbows on the inside. Good uppercut off the right hand from the Filipino. This is more like it from Eustaquio. Offering his head, hoping to sucker Moraes in. Playing baiting games with the Brazilian is Geje Eustaquio. High knee from the Muay Thai clinch from Moraes.
Just barely missed. Good takedown defense from the Filipino.
The crowd here, the heavy Filipino crowd in Macau, appreciating it. Geje looking through his brow. Moraes shoots him for a takedown. Geje not going down on this occasion.
You can see the stance of Geje is a little bit lower than usual, like his hands are down by his waist for just that reason. He can stop the takedown by reaching his hands under the arms of Moraes. but Moraes is able to get a takedown on this occasion.
Top position for Adriano Moraes. Not where Geje Eustaquio wants to be. And Moraes pass and go to side control, looks to get there. Roll through from Eustaquio, gives up his back. This could be dangerous, Mitch.
Good scramble by Geje, but in that roll, he does give up his back and allows Moraes to get one hook in. Moraes is nice and tight to the back. Look for him to take that right arm and try to shove it under the chin of Geje.
Geje is going to have to defend the choke here.
Good scramble by Geje. Back to half guard.
Defend he does, Eustaquio, but what can he do off his back here? This is Moraes' territory.
You can see him posted on that hip, trying to prevent Moraes from moving forward and advancing his position, and he's able to get back into full guard.
Opens up the guard, throws the legs up, bends an elbow. Good work there from Eustaquio, keeping busy off his back. Closes the guard again, does the Filipino. 1 minute five remains, third round of five. Eustaquio, having gone further than he did against Moraes 4 years ago, where he was subbed out in the second round, glances to his corner for some instruction. Does Geje Eustaquio?
What's up, Uncle Ed?
What's Moraes looking to do here, Mitch?
He's trying to step over the guard of Geje, so he's trying to like control posture, drop a little bit of ground and pound, and then he tries to see how he's trying to swing his left leg over. He's trying to step over the guard of Geje and work to advance his position. But Jehe's doing a very good job of keeping his guard in place, but Moraes is able to get past. Now he's in half guard. 27 seconds left to work.
Geje hoping for the up kicks, gets them off now. That one to the midsection of Moraes. Oh, Moraes plows through with a straight right hand to the nose. That had some power behind
it.
This crowd screaming every time he's stuck where it lands. Even off his back, and we're going into the fourth. Your thoughts so far, Mitch?
Very good round for Moraes. He was able to close the distance, pressure Geje up against the cage, and continually attack with the takedowns. There he is, landing a big right hand. Here he goes. Geje had the underhooks, but Moraes just picks him up and throws him onto his back. Here's that big right hand, how he was just able to cut through the guard and drop a big bomb on Geje. Now, that championship experience of Moraes is starting to show. He's starting to turn up the volume on some of these shots, and now we're entering the championship rounds. This is where champions are made.
Seconds out, please.
How do you see the evolutionary path of Eustaquio in handling the grappling of Moraes? Because on the ground, Moraes has been dominant.
It's every single one of Team Lakay's improved on the ground. And I am actually very impressed with Jehe's guard. He's able to maintain his guard in a lot of these positions with his legs wrapped around Moraes. Moraes before was cutting through his guard like a hot knife through butter. And now Geje is able to maintain that guard, and really stop a lot of the damage from happening.
Mitch, you were in Baguio City a couple of months ago. You saw Geje training firsthand.
Man, these guys train so hard with so much intensity, and they all train at altitude. So you can almost feel your lungs start to collapse up there, and these guys are just used to it. That's why they get better and better with each round. But look at the champion. Looks just as fresh as he was in the first round.
Eustaquio needs to start applying the pressure, and he's striking. Cannot afford for Moraes to dictate the pace on the feet and to dictate on the ground. Oh, the high kick. Snap the taste out of his mouth. Outside leg kick misses the target for the Brazilian.
See, this is the stance that Geje normally employs. His hands are very close to his chin, and he keeps his guard up. And he's dropping his hands in a lower guard stance to prevent the takedowns from happening.
Moraes has Eustaquio on his back again. Butterfly hook from Eustaquio. Moraes looking to pass.
good job by Geje to recover back to full guard. You can see, like, when Geje puts his feet on the hips of Moraes, Moraes kind of flops down. That's so Geje slips the foot off of the hip, and so he can step over and advance his position.
Back to his feet here, tries to plow through the guard with that right hand, as he did in the previous round. Adriano Moraes, the champion on top. Well, both champions, but the true champion, Moraes, the interim champion, on his back, Geje Eustaquio. A unification bout here. Where does Geje go from here? What will the corner be telling him, Mitch?
Right now, he's just trying to control the posture, so Moraes is not able to posture up, create a little bit of space, and start landing shots.
And there's a shot as he postured up and created that space from Moraes.
Typically, the rule of thumb is that when you're in a defensive position, you need to create space on your opponent so you can get away. And usually the opposite is true when you're trying to attack, is you want to eliminate that space and crush your opponent.
2 minutes 20 remaining, fourth round of five. Looks to pass the guard. Eustaquio stuffs that attempt, though.
It's pass one. Now he's trying to use that other leg to step through. Good job by Geje to stay in half guard.
Defensively doing well on the ground, Geje Eustaquio, but he needs some offense. He needs to start putting down some points.
See, look at that. He spin around. Now he's attacking the leg. Good job by Geje after getting dominated on the ground.
Oh, he takes down Moraes. It's deafening in here.
And the crowd erupts.
Eustaquio, that's going to do wonders for his confidence. Here he comes now with the boxing jab, too. Throws the jab again, the Filipino. Has he got his second win now? Can he start to establish his authority in the striking? Deafening chance for Eustaquio inside Studio City. Minute five now. A seesawing battle. There's a question mark kick. A Brazilian kick from the Brazilian. Outside lead kick from Eustaquio.
This is a very close round. So far, it's a lot of back and forth action from both guys. I like to see Eustaquio put a little bit of heat on Moraes. Same thing with Moraes. I like to see him start advancing the position. Olivia Cost might call for action soon.
What about a low level single leg there? Eustaquio. That's the left hand, not connecting for him. Jumping near Moraes. Looks for a counter left as Eustaquio. Some much better signs from Geje in this fourth round. Defends the takedown, sprawls out back to his feet, almost took a knee to the jaw. Jumping knee again from Moraes, wants a takedown, gets it. Final seconds, they're gonna go into the fifth.
Nice little exclamation point on that round from Moraes. Geje did everything he could, but the jumping knee to the takedown was enough to score at that end of the round. You can see Geje catching one on the chin there. Moraes, beautiful, done through the straight right hand, went in for the outside trip, laced the leg, grabbed Eustaquio to the ground. Here's Geje going after a takedown of his own, sends Moraes for a ride and putting him on his back.
All right, Mitch, where do we stand so far? One round remaining. We score an overall bout. Who is in control? Who's leading the way?
In my unofficial opinion, I have got to give, if the match was stopped right now, a slight edge to the champion, Adriano Moraes.
Fifth, he's
just controlling the ground positions a little bit more.
The old saying goes, Mitch, you've got to do more to arrest the title from the champion.
They both got titles.
The true champion. Okay, can Geje Eustaquio become the unified champion, or will Moraes retain the title? 5 minutes remaining. And a chance go up for Eustaquio to get a driving takedown attempt here from Moraes. Gets it down, goes to side control. An aggressive start from the champ.
Moraes doesn't want to do any more of the stand-up. He immediately shoots in for a double leg and gets it. But look at Jay!
Guillotine! Can he find the finish now?
Oh, he's starting to extend the body. Look at his body. He's extending it out. That's tough. That's close. Jay's got to fight it off. Oh, he does it!
He pops the head out like a jack in the box. And here comes the ground and pound for the Filipino.
Uh-oh.
It's crazy here in Macau, China.
Look at him. He's on top. Jay's going to drop a little bit of ground and pound.
Absolute pandemonium every time Geje Eustaquio gets on top or lands a blow.
Moraes' corner almost jumped into the ring there in excitement. But good job by Geje to tough out the choke and remain on top in the last 3 minutes and 30 seconds.
Let's see what Geje can do on top of the BJJ multi-champion, of the ONE Championship World Champion. Moraes trying to get back to his feet. Geje wants to keep him down. Pushes him like a wheelbarrow. Tries to keep him in the red corner. Belly's back now standing. Is this enough from Geje Eustaquio, Mitch? What a round from the Filipino here in the fifth.
At this, it's not enough. But if he can continue this roll right now, do a little bit of knees. Oh, look at Adriano Moraes rolling for a leg lock.
As he locked it on, is Geje in trouble here?
He's got the leg crossed over the body, so Geje can actually attack here as well. It's kind of a 50-50 position. Let's see if Geje gets a knee bar here on the black belt.
The biggest shock result. The biggest shock result would be if Geje submits Moraes.
I have to agree with that one. But right now, Moraes is the one on top. Look at Geje battling to get back to his feet, but Moraes stops him from getting back up.
Inside the closed guard. We're past the halfway point of this final round. And what a cracking round it's been for Geje Eustaquio of the Philippines. He's got the Brazilian inside his guard. The closed guard. Trying to posture up, trying to land the ground and pound the last. Geje just escaped the knee. This crowd screams and shrieks for the Filipino. Finally again from Moraes. Geje's going to be careful of those rising Muay Thai knees. Here come the chance again for Geje. Overhand right from Moraes. Geje powers back, shoots in with Moraes. Geje looks to stuff it, and he does.
Oh, good job by Geje to remain on his feet. Now he's got double underhooks. Let's see what he can do with this. See if he changes. Oh, good shrug of the shoulder there to take the back of Moraes.
Trying to reach into the canvas. Not allowed to suplex here. Oh, how about this from Moraes?
Beautiful dive there, rolled right into the leg lock. That's a knee bar. He's trying to go under the armpit now. Ah, that's tight, but Jay's got to push. He's got to push. Use that other leg. Use the left leg to create space, and he's out.
Geje out of trouble. 1 minute remaining now. This match on fire in the final round. And Geje a takedown. A back and forth contest. Time for the knees, and Geje throws to the shoulder. A roll through again for the champ.
Again, attacking the leg with the knee bar. Geje is consistently getting the back position. Now he's got the back a little bit, but you can see Moraes is coming on top and attacking the leg.
Under 30 seconds remaining. It is defeat. I can't hear myself thinking here in Studio City. Moraes top position. The ground and pound from the champion. In half guard now. Can he pass? This place is shaking! A sellout crowd here in Macau.
Geje Eustaquio.
Now that is what a unification bout should be. Both athletes putting everything on their way.
And now, after five rounds of battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one scores this bout in favor of the red corner. Judge number two scores this bout in favor of the blue corner. And Judge